sincerity and their relative normalcy also stands out. I thought Michael that Jackson. Was elegant in its simplicity and its sincerity, and family, it was totally appropriate in every sense.
And the millions of fans who have sang and danced, or at least tried to do so, like Mr. Michael Jackson. He was often imitated, but never duplicated. He wanted to heal the world through his music, and in a small way, he succeeded. His music reached across the barriers of race, culture, and even national identity, unifying the planet, if only for a few moments. So now it's up to us. We should all look at the man or the woman in the mirror and change the way we treat each other. Let's celebrate our uniqueness, respect our differences, and make that change starting today. My prayer is that this will be more than just a memorial for Michael Jackson, but a remembrance truly of what he means to us. Because all around us are people of different cultures, different religions, different nationalities, and yet the music of Michael Jackson brings us together, not only here, but around the world. The family has allowed me to close this memorial with a prayer, and I'm going to ask that you would just catch the hand of the person next to you, whether you're in this auditorium or watching by television, wherever you might be, in solidarity and remembrance of truly what Michael Jackson's music has done to us and what the man means in this place. If you are so inclined, will you bow your heads and let's pray. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you this day for the memory of Michael Jackson that means so much to us even right now. Thank you for the gift of music that he gave us. Thank you for the man that he was and for what he sought to do with his life. We pray, Father, that you will just remind us that we truly can make a difference if we make up our minds to do so. Help us to take a message of love and healing and peace with us as we go. Let us demonstrate that love when we go to school. Let us demonstrate that love when we go to work. Let us demonstrate that love as we walk the streets of our city and no longer turn a blind eye to the needs of those that we walk by every day. Let us stop judging people by the color of their skin and by the accent of their voice. Let us rather look in the heart of every man, woman, boy, and girl and desire truly to reach that person with the love that Michael Jackson showed us in his music. But even now, the King of Pop must bow his knee to the King of Kings. And we pray that you remind us, Lord, that our lives are but dust. We are here for a moment and then we are gone. Thank you, Lord, for how Michael impacted us, and may we now impact others. For we pray that this moment will not be forgotten as an event to have been enjoyed, but rather a reminder that we too can make a change. Bless us and keep us with the love by which you kept Michael. And we offer this prayer unto you in the glorious name of Jesus our Lord, that all who agree say amen. God bless you and praise God for you.
Smokey Robinson, Mariah Carey, Queen Latifah, Lionel Richie, Berry Gordy, Stevie Wonder, Kobe Bryant, Magic Johnson, Jennifer Hudson, John Mayer. But for me, I think it was Brooke Shields. I don't think I'd ever heard someone talk about what Michael Jackson was like when the doors were closed and he was being a kid. I thought she was quite impressive.
And the other contemporary of Michael Jackson, Al Sharpton, also was soaring in his rhetoric. Remember, they were all child stars together, basically, and almost the same age. And it did resonate. It did. Reverend Al did, and Brooke Shields, that deeply sincere and so nice to see her and looking so lovely and so deeply affected by the passing of her friend. I remember all those crazy stories about those two and how the paparazzi hounded them mercilessly, and to have her there, I think, was also entirely fitting. But I think that the memory that we will all take away from this is of those children. Those children, that 11-year-old daughter of his, and that handsome 12-year-old son, and we even got some shots of Prince Michael II, also known as Blanket, and to see how well they have endured these years on Earth, so extraordinary, so I was going to say abnormal, but unnormal in every sense of the word, fleeting from a sheik in the Persian Gulf's mansion to someplace else, hiding in a hotel in London. Never being able to go back to Neverland, where the older ones certainly remember the rides and everything else. Daddy, why can't we go back? And Daddy probably not mentioning the fact that, well, maybe because it was here that the law enforcement from Santa Barbara descended on my sanctuary and in many ways disrupted and destroyed my life for whatever I did. I don't know, that we'll ever know the facts to that. But it was, I have to say that given the time they had, and this was the professionals, these were the people, Ehrlich and Sunshine and Ortega there, who really were in charge of Michael Jackson, the performer, and how nice they get a chance to produce this final show.
Greta Van Susteren was inside Staples Center for this final show. And, Greta, I've heard Michael Jackson called so many different things over the years. This is the first time that I've ever heard him called Daddy, and I may not forget it.
Yeah. Well, Shep, you've been in these events. Is that, watching it at home, it's very powerful. Being in the same room, you can almost feel it coming across the arena when the little girl started to cry. I mean, there wasn't a single person in this environment that wasn't hugely affected by it. And then you couple with what you said about Brooke Shields. Brooke Shields said everyone thought that they were the odd couple on the outside, but to themselves, they weren't odd at all. And it certainly does send a little bit of a message maybe to some of us in the media that maybe we ought to tone it down a little bit, dial it back in how we criticize people for being a little bit different and making the assumption because they may seem unusual or odd or weird that there might be something wrong with them. But when you see the wonderful kids and you see all the good things he's done in his life, obviously this is a day when we celebrate. We only look at the good things someone has done at an event like this, and I'm sure there'll be time in the future to be having a more critical eye. But there's no question that people in this room are celebrating all the many good things that Michael Jackson did in terms of charities and also the genius of his music. But when that little girl got up and started to cry, I think that's that really ratcheted up a lot for everybody in this room and Brooke Shield too, Shep.
Indeed. Young Paris, what a life they have already led, and so much ahead with so many questions left unanswered.
Yeah, imagine,
producers have
imagine
been able to
Shep.
Put together a look back on the day thus far, and we'll have that for you as Fox News coverage continues in just a moment.